We are standing in the middle of the campus of Ag and Life Sciences here on the UW-Madison campus. This morning I'm with Dick Cates. He is with the Wisconsin School of Beginning Dairy and Livestock Farmers. And Christina Hempstead, she is a new farmer going into an incredible and kind of exploding new field. Dick, can you talk about, we're here to promote the ride to farm. You're in your eighth year. What's the significance of this ride?
Absolutely, and thank you for taking the time. The significance, first of all, of the ride to farm is to help the public understand the real importance of a next generation on our working lands, on our farmlands in Wisconsin. These are young entrepreneurs that are out going into rural areas developing businesses. To promote that as a significant thing in our culture. The other part, of course, is we're trying to raise funds for our beginning farmer training program here at the College of Ag and Life Sciences so that we can help these young farmers get the training, the entrepreneurship, business planning they need.
You are going into a field that is changing very rapidly. It's not the typical family farm like it used to be, and you grew up on one. Talk about how farming's changed for you and what you hope to do in the future.
Well, I think that there are so many different types of farms that we really have to address, and I'm studying agroecology, which deals with not just the production and the economics of the business, but also the environment and the social aspects and community. So I think it's really an important field.
Talk about some of the crops that we were talking about this off camera earlier, but that you hope to look at growing that might be a little bit different than traditional.
Well, I'd like to consider growing perennial crops, which means you don't have to plant them every year, and so you don't have to till up the soil. Right now we're experimenting with blueberries and maybe some different crops like apples or cherry trees.
Dick, the significance of this ride, again, I mean, really will go to help farmers that are looking to get it. You said a lot of new farmers are not typically from a farm background.
Right. The demographics have changed so dramatically. We have so many fewer traditional farms in place now, and yet think about, we all know of the interest in the local and regional foods. People want to know their farmers, and so we have hundreds of kids who want to be farmers because they want to work for themselves. They want to do something with the land, with the natural resources that feels good. And so that's what we train.
Well, the ride to farm is a chance to get out and support these students as well as get out and experience what some of the local farms have to
Absolutely.
Offer. So thanks so much for joining us this morning. We really appreciate it. And we'll have all the information for Ride to Farm at NBC15.com. Just look under News Links. We'll be right back.